Miguel!
Hi guys!
Too fly, yo, what's up?
Too gamer, game on!
Too fresh, that's right, bro.
Too gangster, how you doing?
Michael!
The big boss is too cool, and be cool! The Too Cool Crew!
Biohazard 2.
Backup! I need backup!
A rookie cop facing unspeakable evil.
There's something really wrong here. These things aren't dying. I just blasted this thing, and it's still alive!
One of the most anticipated games of 1998, Resident Evil 2. If the suspense doesn't kill you, something else will.
Everyone's gonna die!
What is up to all the two members of the Too Cool Crew? My name is Tier Gamer, and guess what guys, today we are going to be playing one of my favorite Resident Evil games, and that guys is of course the one and only, the original Resident Evil 2 guys. Yes guys, we are continuing on this series of playing all of the Resident Evil games, and we just got done playing Resident Evil 1, which was a lot of fun, but now this time we're going to be playing of course one of my favorite games that actually got me into the Resident Evil series, and that's of course Resident Evil 2 guys. And I'm excited for this guys, man. I cannot tell you, man, the first time that I actually played Resident Evil 2 was it was scary, dude. I did not know what the heck I was getting myself into, and I still remember from this day, man, that the first time that I played Resident Evil 2, I got so freaking scared at the port, not the liquor, which is so freaking surprising. The liquor didn't scare me when I first saw him in Resident Evil 2. The thing that freaking scared me is when you went into that hallway where all those boarded up windows were at, and then you come back, because you actually go into that section of the police station like twice. You go there once, and then when you come back again, all of a sudden you get these zombie hands that just basically pop out of nowhere and they grab you. That right there is what got me so freaking scared and not play Resident Evil 2 again until I got a little bit more older and started playing the game and beating it. So yeah guys, so that right there will always remain as one of my scariest moments in Resident Evil 2, is when I went into that hallway, the zombie arms grabbed you in the hallway, and that right there I basically just stopped playing the game. So yeah guys, so yeah, Resident Evil 2 holds a very special place in my heart, man, and I'm really happy that they actually remade the game years later. It took a long time, but we finally got the remake, and I am gonna go ahead and play that, but we gotta go ahead and play the originals first, and then we're gonna go ahead and play the remakes, and yeah, so I'm excited for that guys. But yeah guys, Resident Evil 1 was a lot of fun. Really happy that we're able to go ahead and do a two plays on it, and we were able to go ahead and beat it, so really awesome. So now we're gonna be moving on to Resident Evil 2, and again, we're going to be playing the game twice. We're going to be playing both Claire's and Leon's scenario. And if I can, I'll try to go ahead and play as Hunk's scenario, which is the fourth survivor. I think if I remember, in order for you to go ahead and get that, you have to basically beat the game twice with both Claire and Leon. So I'm going to try to see if I can go ahead and do that. But yeah, I'm excited for this, guys. This is going to be freaking awesome, because I've been wanting to go ahead and do a two plays on this for a long time. And finally, I had the chance to do it. And as you guys can see, the setup looks a lot more different, not only in my background, but right here you guys can see that on the screen, you guys can see right there it says Nintendo GameCube, but you also see right there on the bottom it says Wii menu. That's only because I'm actually playing this on the Wii. So yeah, I'm actually one of the few people that still has a Wii, and this Wii, which is actually the black Wii, I actually got this like a long time ago when I was a kid. And man dude, I cannot tell you, when I first got the Wii, it was a lot of fun dude, and yeah, I still have it to this day. But yeah, it still works, which I'm really, really happy about it, and I still got the nunchucks, so yeah. Yeah, the nunchucks are still here. You guys can see it right here on my screen. So, yeah, I still got the nunchucks. Unfortunately, I need to go ahead and get some new ones because these are, you know, they're starting to wore out. But, I still have the nunchucks. I actually had two sets, but then I lost the other set. So, I still got the first one. So, yeah. But either way, yeah, guys, this is going to be awesome. Also, like I said, my setup looks a lot more different right here in the background. I actually moved it into a different room because my old room is actually going to be remodeled. So I'm actually moving it into a different room. As you guys can see, the background looks a lot more different. You guys can see I have a mic stand, which is freaking awesome. I didn't actually think I was going to go ahead and get myself a mic stand, but you know what? I just went on ahead and get it. I just got this yesterday. And yeah, it's freaking awesome, dude. So and the reason why I wanted to go ahead and get a mic stand is because unfortunately right when I moved into this new room is basically the mic was a little bit too far from where my audio is, like from where my face is at. So basically it was actually a little bit too far away and I wasn't able to go ahead and get the proper audio of when I'm speaking. I was decided to go ahead and get basically like a chair in front of me and put like a box there and put the mic right there. How I did it back then, because that's how I used to do my recordings. That's how I was able to go ahead and do it. I actually used the microphone on the headphones, but then I switched it to the microphone once I got myself a microphone. Then I was able to go put a chair in a box and I put the microphone right there back in the day when I first started doing the YouTube videos. That's how I used to do it before. But then, you know, yeah, right when I moved into this new room, I was like, okay, dude, I think it's time for me to go and get a mic stand. And yeah, it's working properly, so I'm really happy about it. I had to go ahead and get adjusted to it, but yeah, it works out perfectly, so I'm really happy about it. But anyways, so now that we got that out of the way, let's not waste some more time, guys, because we are going to be playing some Resident Evil 2, one of my favorite games it just holds a very special place in my heart, dude. So I'm really happy that I'm able to go ahead and play this. And so let's not waste some more time. And let's go ahead and play some Resident Evil 2, guys. Let's go ahead and play some Resident Evil 2. Let me go ahead and go with start. And there we go. The classic Wii noise. Oh, man. I'm so freaking happy. Now, I do have my controller, you know. Of course, I'm actually playing this on the Wii, so I'm actually using a GameCube controller. So, yeah. Resident Evil 2. Ah, man, I cannot tell you, dudes. I cannot tell you how freaking excited I am for this. So, I'm just freaking excited. but yeah, so let's go ahead and do it the proper way. So we get to play both Claire and Leon scenario, but we're gonna be going in order. We're gonna be playing as Claire first, and then we're gonna be playing as Leon. So that way we will be able to go ahead and get ourselves, of course, the proper ending of the game, and of course the proper way how it's supposed to end. So yeah. But either way, so let's go ahead and play as Claire. Let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so we have the original game. We have I never actually found out what this arrange means. Because I remember when I played Resident Evil 2 on the Nintendo 64. Because I actually have two different copies of Resident Evil 2. I have the GameCube version and I have the Nintendo 64 version. But the main one that I actually played the most was actually the Nintendo 64, because that's the one that I grew up on. And I still have my Nintendo 64 with me. In my collection. So yeah, but either way, I want to make sure everything's all good the way how everything was set up when I first got this, because I remember when I finally got this on eBay, and I was so freaking happy that I was able to go ahead and get it. And I want to make sure that the setup is all nice and good. So let me see. Yeah, I think everything's all good. Okay, the rumble on stereo. Okay, I think we're pretty much good. Okay, so let's go ahead and go with the original game. And there's only two modes, of course, normal and easy. Unlike Resident Evil, like the first one, it actually had three different, you know, different game modes, but now this one only has two, so let's go with normal. Resident Evil 2. Let's do it, boys! Let's do it! Oh, I'm so freaking happy. Sorry if I was yelling into the mic. I'm just so freaking excited, dude.
A bizarre incident occurred in the outskirts of an American suburb called Raccoon City. It was later revealed that the terrible disaster.
I want to try my best. By the T-virus, if I messed up.
A mutagenic toxin.
Because it's been like
the International Enterprise Umbrella
it's been quite a bit. So pretty much produced, so I'll try my best. Sorry if you hear the squeak this much. I'm just adjusting it.
The Raccoon City Police Department's Special STARS Unit immediately began investigation in the affair. The case was apparently closed, thanks to the efforts of STARS members Chris Redfield and Jill Valentine.
Yay!
But the Umbrella Corporation's experiments were far from finished.
Damn you, Umbrella, messing things up like always. Why? Why, man? I'm just so freaking happy, dude. I'm just so freaking happy. Man, this is just bringing back my childhood, dude. Ah, man. Me as a little kid didn't know what the heck I was getting myself into when I played this game. Ah.
I'm finally here.
Oh, here we go. The most iconic line.
Guy's a maniac. Why'd he bite me?
Why'd he bite me? I love this guy, dude. This guy's a maniac. Why'd he bite me? Oh, God.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello? Hello?
Gross.
Look,
my duty in a dead body?
I bothered you, okay? Just don't come any closer. Are you listening?
One clear one!
Wait! Don't shoot!
Get down!
Headshot.
We can't stay out here. Head to the police station. It'll be a lot safer.
One!
There! Buckle up.
Okay.
Yes.
What's going on? I arrived in town, and the whole place went insane!
The radio's out!
You're a cop, right?
Yeah, first day on the job. Great, huh? Name's Leon Kennedy. Nice to meet you.
Mine's Claire. Claire Redfield. I came to find my brother, Chris.
What a great way to start off your job, right? The zombie apocalypse. Get into some action!
Could you open the glove box?
Sure. There's a gun inside.
Better take it with you.
Oh shit! It's Leon's twin brother!
You okay?
Still in one piece.
The zombie!
Run!
Jesus!
Claire!
Leon!
station. I'll meet you there.
Okay.
Oh, God. We're doing it. We are doing it. We are doing it, guys. Oh, God. They were parted by an inescapable destiny. This is just the beginning of their worst nightmare. Oh, God. I'll try my best. Don't bite me, please. I apologize if I might mess up on some stuff. Might be a little bit rusty. Like I said, I haven't played the game in a bit. So I'll try my best.
Oh, God.
Woof. There we go. I thought I was going to mess up on that. Again, I'm playing this on the GameCube controllers because I was so used to playing it on the Nintendo 64 controllers, but now this time I'm playing on the GameCube controllers, so yeah. And also, of course, you know, we just got done playing Resident Evil, the first one, and right there I had to get adjusted with the PlayStation controllers. So yeah, different controllers, man, you had to go ahead and get adjusted to them. The same thing with the Wii controllers, so yeah. Either way, we're in Kendall's gun shop.
Freeze.
So...
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm a human. Don't shoot.
Don't shoot! I'm a human!
Yeah. Nope.
Ooh. Sorry about that, babe. I thought you were one of them.
What's going on in this town?
Hold on. I ain't got no clue, darling. By the time I noticed something was wrong, the entire city was infested with zombies.
Yep.
But don't you worry, girlie. You'll be safe in here.
Girlie?
I'm keeping a close eye on things.
This freaking guy. One cool thing that in the remake, they actually... we were able to go ahead and play as this guy in the DLC in Resident Evil 2, so... Really awesome. And they actually gave us a little bit more story with him because, but here we actually didn't get that much story with Kendo, but in the remake, they actually gave us a little bit more story with him and his daughter. So yeah. But either way, let's continue on. Now, there are some items right here that we can pick up, but I'm not gonna go ahead and pick up any items only because, you'll be able to go ahead and get yourself a special key in this game. And with that special key, you'll be able to go ahead and get yourself some outfits right here in Resident Evil 2. So yeah, you can actually change your character's outfits. The same thing as what you did in Resident Evil 1. When you beat Resident Evil 1, you'll be able to go ahead and get yourself a special key. And with that key, you'll be able to go ahead and get yourself some new outfits for your character. So that's what we're going to be doing. But in order for us to go ahead and get the special key, we basically had to go ahead and make our way to the police station without picking up anything. We cannot pick up anything. No weapons, no ammo, no herbs, anything like that, nothing. Because if we actually do pick up an item, that right there is not going to give us a special key. And we won't be able to go ahead and get that key from a very special person that we actually did, meet in Resident Evil. Oh, what was that? Oh, yeah, I was about to go to pause. So, yeah, sorry about that. But, yeah, so we are going to be meeting somebody special that everybody knows who it is. And he is actually somebody that was actually in the first Resident Evil game. We didn't get to see him, but we actually heard his voice. So, yeah. But either ways, let's go ahead and trigger this cutscene, and then we'll just get out of here. Crap. Yeah, fortunately for Kendo, he didn't make it. Oh, yeah. Forgot. I think there was some files that we can pick up. Oh, no, there's no files. Okay, never mind. Screw it. I thought there was going to be some files to pick up here. Again, haven't played the game in a while, so apologize for that. Yep, unfortunately for Kendo, he didn't make it, but we're still alive. So, let's see if I can go ahead and get these zombies out of the way before I get bit. Well, I'm gonna be getting bit either way, but I'm just gonna try to do my best, try not to get bit as much. Get off me, you goddamn piece of shit! Again, we're going to try to avoid not to pick up anything because I want to go ahead and get that special key. Unfortunately, I had to go ahead and get bit in the process, but luckily for me, we can actually shove the zombies a lot quicker right here in Resident Evil 2 than in Resident Evil 1. So yeah. Oh, this bitch is gonna bite me. Ah, damn, got that bitch, man. Yeah. Damn it, there's actually like multiple zombies here. Wait for that guy to turn around. Okay, we're good. Woof! Damn it. That chick right there in the corner is a little bit tricky trying to go ahead and get past it, but I tried my best. Jesus! One! Yeah, these guys are eating a meal, so I do not want to go ahead and disturb them. Dude, I cannot wait until we finish Resident Evil 2. I cannot wait to go ahead and play Resident Evil 3, because that way we'll be able to go ahead and explore Resident Evil 3 in Raccoon City. Oh, she's gonna bite me. Oh no, we're good. We're still good. One. Knock this ass down. Oh yeah, there's a fire right here. No? Is this something right here? Oh, there we go. Oh no, never mind. What the? I thought there was gonna be a fire right there that we can pick up. Never mind. Got that one. Oh crap. Try my best. Don't bite me, please. Don't bite me, please. God damn it. Oh. Oh, you piece of shit. You got him from behind. Okay, not doing so well. Oh, great. I'm slowing down. Well, that didn't work properly. But we made it. We made it to the police station. Crap, I messed that up. Yeah, look at this. Yeah, we're in danger now because of that situation. But luckily for us, we made it to the police station. It didn't go as smooth as I thought it was going to go. But you know what? We're still alive, so that's all that matters. But let me go ahead and okay, hold on a second. Let me go ahead and get this green herb here. Okay, back on caution. Okay, so let me go into the police station first. And let me get some bullets, because now, not that we made our way to the police station, now we could go ahead and start picking up some items. Yeah, I could have made through that area without, without getting bitten by the zombies. But I had to go ahead and use my gun in the process. I was only able to use the bullets that I had in my inventory at the moment. So let me go ahead and go outside again. And we're going to go ahead and meet ourselves a very special person that everybody should know. Because this person was actually in the first Resident Evil game, and he basically left us for dead. And if you guys want to know who that is, this is, of course, hey, look who it is. Oh, crap, one button. Now, if anybody does not know who this is, this right here is actually Brad. And Brad is actually the pilot that was actually in the first Resident Evil game that basically just left us. He basically just left us for dead in Resident Evil 1, and then he came back again towards the end and gave us the rocket launcher to kill the tyrant. So yeah, so unfortunately for Brad, we came back to the police station, the whole Raccoon City got infected, and unfortunately for Brad, he got infected too, so yeah, he got turned into a zombie. But remember when I told you guys about that special key? Yep, Brad actually has that special key, and we have to go ahead and kill Brad in order for us to go ahead and get that special key. But Brad is a bit of a tough boy. He's actually a lot more stronger than the other zombies. So he basically has kind of like the same amount of health as the Lickers. So Brad is going to be a tough boy to kill. But we'll try our best not to get bit and not get killed by him. So yeah. Hey Brad, my dude. Get down. Remember what I said, Brad? Oh crap! I was trying to turn around. God dang it! Oh, that didn't work. I keep pressing the wrong button. Yep. Excuse me. Are you still up? Well, I think I shot his arm off. Are you still alive? See if I can get a knife on him. Oh my god, I keep pressing the wrong button. I keep on thinking that I'm using the PlayStation controller. Hey! Step your ass. Oh my god, god dang it. I need to get used to the GameCube controller. Hey, Brad. Hey, Brad. Is he dead? Victory! He's dead. There we go. So now that we killed Brad, and guess what? We got the special key. There we go, guys. So now that we got the special key, we'll be able to go ahead and use this to get a cool-looking outfit for Claire. Oh my god, I did it again. God dang it. I apologize if I keep on pressing the wrong button. I need to get used to the game controller. I keep pressing the stop button, but it's not the stop button. It's the Y button. Ugh. Either way, now that we got Brad killed, and he bit me, which kind of sucks. But we're still alive. You know, we're still alive. That's all that matters. So let's go ahead and talk to Marvin, because Marvin is here. And let's go ahead and talk to Marvin. Oh man! That's what Leon would say when I played.
Hang in there. Are you the only officer left in the building?
Who are you?
Claire. Claire Redfield. I'm looking for my brother, Chris.
We lost contact with him over 10 days ago. Chris, Jill, Barry. Every last STARS team member has disappeared. We should have listened to them.
What happened?
About 2 months ago, there was this incident involving these zombie-like creatures in a mansion located in the outskirts of this city. Chris and the other STARS members discovered that Umbrella was behind everything, at the risk of their own lives. But no one believed them.
Are you okay?
Don't worry about me. Just rescue the survivors in the other rooms. Here, take this key card. You should be able to unlock the doors in the hall with this. Now go.
But...
just go.
He's got a gun.
Okay. Just hang in there. I'll be back soon.
See ya, Marvin. We'll be back. Now, of course, he locked the door. Now, one cool thing that in Resident Evil 2 Remake, that they actually were able to go and give Marvin a lot more character, which is really awesome. And, yeah, really cool. So let's go ahead and use the key card to unlock the doors. We use the blue key card. One. Two. Okay. There we go, all the doors are open, and ink ribbon, let's take that, and go for us to save the game. Okay, let's go in here, and let's go ahead and use the storage box, just like in the previous Resident Evil game. Put that there. The key. Oh god, I don't want to use the key. Yeah, because the key's gonna be used actually pretty soon. Yeah. What was that? A file. Police Memorandum? There we go. I probably said that wrong. Either way, 8/23/1998. Oh, dude, I was 4 years old. I was born in 1994. Hey, look at that. Ah, yes. Either way, this letter is just to inform everyone about the recent movement of equipment that has happened during the precinct rearrangement. The safe with four-digit lock has been moved from the Star's office on the second floor to the Eastern office on the first floor, 2236. Okay, Raccoon Police Liaison Department. Okay, 2236. And if I remember, I know what that is. I know where that safe is at. Lockpick. Okay, got the first ace spray. Now, the same thing as, you know, what happened in Resident Evil 1 is the same thing that's going to be happening in Resident Evil 2. With each different character have their own, you know, different gimmick to them. Like, of course, Claire has the lockpick, so she's basically going to be able to go ahead and basically unlock those drawers like you did in Resident Evil 1 with Jill. And with Leon, he actually has like a lighter. So yeah, so the lighter isn't actually an item that it is an item that you'll be able to go and pick up, but that's actually already in Claire's scenario. But on Leon's, you'll be able to go ahead and pick up the small keys in order for you to go ahead and unlock the drawers. So yeah, so it's basically kind of like a switcheroo. Right there. So with with Claire, her special item that she gets is a lockpick, and with Leon, his special item he gets is actually the lighter. With Claire, you have to actually pick up the lighter, and with Leon, you have to pick up the small keys. So yeah, each different character has a bit of a swap to them when it comes to the item. So yeah, and if I remember, I think when it comes to the amount of health both Claire and Leon have, I think it's like the same amount of health they both get. Yeah, so this time it's not like one character has more health than the other, or one character, you know, can stand more damage. I think they're kind of like the same, except for the inventory. I think with the inventory might be the same. I think it might be... White? Oh, no. I think they did increase the inventory for Leon. Well, I think it's the same. I think it might be 6 slots, maybe. I don't know. Like I said, it's been a bit since I played Resident Evil 2. So yeah, I want to try to do my best, try to remember this stuff I can. But either way, now that we got the first aid spray, let's go ahead and get our health all the way up and let's move on. Oh crap! Hey yo, guys. Did you guys see what was that out in the window? Something basically just crawled around the window. And I remember the first time that I saw that, I thought I was just seeing things. Because you know when you're a little kid, your imagination when you're a little kid it's a mind of its own. And it basically just takes over, man. I thought I saw something when I was a little kid, but then come to find out, no, I wasn't just seeing shit. I wasn't seeing shit. Something did go across the window, and it's of course one of the most iconic enemies in Resident Evil, and that is of course is the liquor. So yeah, dude, it's so freaking crazy that the liquor wasn't the one that scared me, that got me not into playing the game anymore. It was those freaking zombies that came through the windows. So yeah, but anyways, we see a dead body on the floor. The head is missing. It seems to have been twisted off. Damn. I wonder who did that. Also, we do not see the head, though. I remember in this hallway in the remake, they made it a lot more scarier. Especially with that zombies in the corner, you're able to go ahead and lift up their head up, and you see that their face got all slashed. Oh, man. Also, we see some blood dripping. Wonder what that's about. Let's go ahead and check it out. There he is! The dude himself! The liquor! Oh crap. Be careful. Where? Ah, I got him, you piece of shit. Okay, that didn't work. Oh, he was about to do his lunge. Oh, man. You guys remember the Hunters and Resident Evil 1? And you guys remember when the Hunters were able to go ahead and do basically their... Well, the Hunters actually had three different attacks. They had their regular attack, they had their jumping attack, and they had their special one-hit KO attack. Now, with the Licker actually has two attacks. Actually, no, he has three. He has, of course, his slash attack. He has his long-range attack, which is the tongue that he uses. And his other one is his special leap attack. But that leap attack, it doesn't instant kill you. Well, it actually will if you basically have like half your health. But that jumping leap attack that he does, that right there does a insane amount of damage. It basically takes half of your health, so you have to be really careful when it comes to that. When you hear the Licker screech, that right there is a signal that... Oh, right there. That right there is actually a signal that the Licker is going to be doing his special jumping leaping attack. And that right there, you have to be really prepared for it. So yeah, so got to be really careful with the Licker, man. Oh yeah, this is the freaking hallway that got me basically quit playing Resident Evil 2 when I was a kid. This was a freaking hobby, man. Ah, I can't believe this jump scare, man, is what got me not playing Resident Evil for a long time. Oh my god, dude. So many fond memories. Either way. Operation Report. Operation Report, September 26th. The Raccoon Police Department was unexpectedly attacked by zombies. Many have been injured, even more were killed. During the attack, our communications equipment was destroyed and we no longer have contact with the outside. We have decided to carry out an operation with the intent of rescuing any possible survivors as well as to prevent this disaster from spreading beyond Raccoon City. The details of the operation are as follows. Security of armaments. I think I probably said that wrong. And ammunition. Chief Irons has voiced concern regarding the issue of terrorism due to a series of recent unresolved incidents on the very day before the zombies attacked. He made the decision to relocate all weapons to scattered intervals throughout the building as a temporary measure to prevent their possible seizure. Unfortunately, this decision has made it extremely difficult for us to locate all ammunition caches. It has become our top priority to recover these scattered munitions. To unlock the weapon storage, as stated earlier, it will be extremely difficult to secure all the ammunition. However, a considerable supply still remains in the underground weapon storage. Unfortunately, the person in charge of the card key used to access the weapon storage is missing, and we have been unable to locate the key. One of the breakers went down during the battle and the electronic locks are not functioning in certain areas. It has become a top priority to restore the power in the power room and secure those locks. Recorder David Ford. So yeah. Operation Report, September 27th, 1 p.m. The West Barricade has been broken through and another exchange ensued. Sorry about that. We sheltered the injured in the confiscation room on the first floor temporarily. 12 more people were injured in the battle. David Ford recorded. Additional report. 3 additional people were killed following the sudden appearance of an as of yet unknown creature, which is the Licker. This creature is identified by missing patches of skin and razor-like claws. However, its most distinguishing characteristics is its lance-like tongue. Yep, the Licker. capable of piercing a human torso in an instant. Their numbers as well as their location remains unknown. We have tentatively named this creature the Licker and are currently in the process of developing countermeasures to deal with this new threat. Yep. Ah, so that way there is the operation report. So yeah, so when it comes to this, I only know what to do, where to go ahead and find the key. It's actually in the morgue, so yeah. There's actually a morgue at the police station, so we have to go ahead and find the key there. Also, in the remake, this room is a lot more different than the remake too, so yeah. Also, I think there might be something right here. Is there nothing behind here if I remember? No, I don't think there is. Anything over here? Is that a fire we can pick up? No, okay. So there's gonna be something there. No, I think there's nothing else that we can pick up here on this area. No, I think it's just in the back. Okay, so we are gonna be coming back into this room because this room actually is a puzzle room. I think if I remember, there's something that you can pick up here. Or am I wrong? No? Hmm. I swear to God, I thought there was bullets here. Huh. I guess that might be an only a Neo scenario then. Well, either way. So we are going to be coming back to that room because we actually do need a lighter. Because we have to go ahead and light up the fireplace. Because that way there is actually a puzzle. So we just leave that for there for now. I swear to God, I thought you would be able to go pick up bullets there. Oh, there we go again. Press the long ass button. Okay, I think I still have a decent amount of ammo to go ahead and take care of these dudes in here. Now, there's like a bunch of zombies in this area. Hey! Knock your ass out. Okay. Whoa. Yeah, there's like four zombies in here. Minute. I still got a decent amount, but it's left. Oh crap. Oh. So alive! I think they're all dead. Yeah, they're all dead. Except for this guy. Oh wait, no, I think that zombie at the bottom is still alive. God dang it, one button again. Calm down. Okay, we're all dead, perfect. Oh yeah. And there's two green herbs in here. Let's pick those up. Okay. Yeah. That freaking zombie was still alive. Good thing I was able to pay attention. Okay, so, now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and use the box. And let's go ahead and drop off the pistol. And you guys are probably wondering, dude, why are you dropping off the pistol there? Don't you need the pistol to fight against the zombies? To show you guys something, this is actually the room that we're going to be able to go ahead and use a special key in. And the locker that we have to go ahead and use a special key is in this locker. We use a special key, yep. And right here is where we're going to be able to go ahead and change our outfit. So right here, there is one outfit that should fit you. Will you change your outfit? Yes. So we're going to go ahead and change our clothes with Claire. And not only that, but we're also going to be able to go ahead and use a new weapon. There's an old gun here. Yep. Will you take the coat? Yes, we will. Yep, we're going to be using a good old fashioned coat revolver. God dang, I pressed one button again. So yeah, look at that. Now, the only bad thing about this is it only holds 6 bullets, but actually does some good amount of damage to the zombies, so yeah. So, look at this outfit on Claire, you know? Claire now looks like a biker chick. So, yeah, really awesome. either way. So let me go ahead and put this equipment here. And yeah, let's go upstairs now. So yeah, when I first found that out, that you'll be able to go in and change your character's costume in Resident Evil 2, I was so freaking excited. At first, I didn't know how to get the special key until I found out from a YouTube video and I searched it up and... Oh, okay, that's how you do it. Okay. Unfortunately, I didn't know. It took me a couple tries to do it, but once I was able to go ahead and do it, then yeah, we're all good. So either way, there's also another puzzle here that we have to go ahead and do. There's actually a jewel that you guys can see. Something is written on the mountain. The god of sun and the god of moon. Their gaze upon me is the only thing that can release Red Soul. Now what that means is we have to go ahead and move these statues. Because in order for us to go ahead and get that jewel, we have to go ahead and put these statues in a proper area. And the area is actually on the floor, if you guys can see the spot. So you put one statue here. And the other statue, we put on the other side. And then we put this over here. There we go. And, ladies and gentlemen, that right there is going to release the jewel. Awesome. Now we actually need two jewels. Will you take the red jewel? Yes, because we actually gonna be needing a special key item in order for us to progress. So yeah. So we got one jewel. We still need one more. And now we go into the Star's office. Awesome. Okay. This is a picture of a young man. There's a good chance it's her boyfriend. Okay. So I hear this is Chris's office right here. I mean his desk. Chris's diary. August 8th. I talked to the chief today once again, but he refused to listen to me. I know for certain that Umbrella conducted T-virus research in that mansion. Anyone infected turns into a zombie. But the entire mansion went up in that explosion along with any incriminating evidence. Since Umbrella employs so many people in town, no one is willing to talk about the incident. It looks like I'm running out of options. August 17th. We've been receiving a lot of local reports about strange monsters appearing at random throughout the city. This must be the work of Umbrella. August 24th. With the help of Jill and Barry, I finally obtained information vital to this case. Umbrella has begun research on the new G-virus, a variation of the original T-virus. Haven't they done enough damage already? Nope. We talked it over and have decided to fly to the main Umbrella headquarters in Europe. I won't tell my sister about this trip because doing so could put her in danger. Please forgive me, Claire. Well, unfortunately for Claire, she's already in the situation, Chris. so yeah, that right there was Chris's diary. And we got ourselves, of course, the unicorn medal. Now, where do we use this medal? Well, we actually use it in that fountain that's actually in the middle of the police station that we actually got into, like in the main entrance. So that's where we're going to be using it. So yeah. So, yep. This is the police station. And guys, this right here is a picture of the STARS members. Yep, there's the STARS members. Unfortunately, Abe almost a majority of everybody in here is dead, except for Chris, Jill, and Barry. And of course, the man himself, Wesker. So yeah. Also, this desk right here is actually Wesker's. And if I remember, if I press this a lot of times, this is actually gonna take a while, because this is an Easter egg somebody found out, you know, a long time ago, and I didn't actually know about this. But if we press on Wesker's desk like a whole bunch of times, it's gonna unlock like a film. So let me go ahead and try it. I don't know how many times this takes. I think it takes like 30 or 30 times, I think, maybe. I don't know. I'm trying to remember. See if this works on the GameCube version of Resident Evil 2. Because I ain't playing the GameCube version of Resident Evil 2. So we'll see if this works. Oh, there we go! Hey, it worked! You will take the film? Yes. It worked! There we go! Awesome! Okay, I don't think there's nothing here. Nothing here. Okay. Go over here, there's... Oh, okay, so we can't pick up that first aid spray then. Okay. But there is something that we can pick up here. And that is, of course... Yep, the grenade launcher. Haha! Will you take the grenade launcher? Yes! Now, if you guys don't remember, in Resident Evil 1, it was actually called the bazooka. But in Resident Evil 2, it's actually called the grenade launcher. A little bit more different, so yeah. And of course, with the grenade launcher, you'll be able to go ahead and switch to different types of grenades. Incendiary, acid, and of course the regular, so yeah. But that's gonna be awesome. But unfortunately, guys, this right here will be the end of the video, because we actually hit the 50 minute mark. But so far, guys, we've actually made some good progress right here in Resident Evil 2, and I'm so freaking happy, because this is bringing back so many memories, and I can't wait to go in and continue on playing the game. And yeah, guys, it's gonna be a lot of fun. But anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Stay tuned, cool guys. Bye.